Infinix is launching its new phone, which is Infinix S4, with the 32 megapixel front camera and the triple cameras at the back. So you might be excited for the Infinix S4. Infinix already released this phone in many countries. So without wasting your time, let's cut into the video. And before moving on, if you're new to my channel, please don't forget to hit the subscribe button. So either like or dislike, but do subscribe and don't forget to notify for the more videos. So let's continue to the introduction.
सब्सक्राइब कीजिए डेली ट्यूटोरियल्स को और बेल आइकन को दबाइए लेटेस्ट टेक्नोलॉजी वीडियो सबसे पहले देखने के लिए।
Hello everyone, welcome to another video. My name is Sarav, you're watching Daily Tutorials. So in this video, I'm going to tell you about the Infinix S4, which is 32 megapixel front camera and having the three camera at the back side. So you might be wondering that what could be its price. So let me help you that it's the mid-range phone. Either you can say it's a budget phone for the most of the people. In this video, we will talk about what are the key features of this phone, what are the pros, cons, and either you should purchase or not. So do watch this video till the end. So let's continue with some specifications. If you are interested in the box section of the Infinix S4, then let me help you that this phone will have 10 watt charger in the box, including micro USB cable and earphones. Screen protector and back cover are included in the box. So now let's move on to the basic specification of the phone. This phone will come with 6.2 inch HD plus IPS LCD display. It will have with 19:9 inch display including the water drop notch. So you might be interested in the water drop notch. If you are, then you can purchase this phone. Now let's talk about the camera section. It will have 32 megapixel front camera with f2.0 aperture. So it will help you to take the best pictures with the bokeh effects. I will say the best as per the Infinix series, but if you have any other phone, then you can get the good results too. At the back, we have the triple cameras with dual LED flash. If you are concerned that what are these triple cameras will do, so let me help you with this. That it will have 1.8 megapixel, 12 megapixel and 2 megapixel camera. If you are concerned about what are the benefits of these cameras, then 8 megapixel are for the depth sensing, 12 megapixel is the main camera and 2 megapixel is the wide angle lens. So if you are going to purchase this phone, then you can add the backside with the triple camera sensor and dual LED flash. There is a fingerprint sensor to unlock your phone. At the top of the phone, there is nothing, but at the left side, we have dual 4G LTE nano SIM card slots with one micro SD card slot. So yes, you can use the 4G SIMs in the two SIM cards, including one micro SD card. At the right side, we have only power button and volume records as usual. But at the bottom, we have 3.5mm jack, including a speaker and the most important thing is the USB 2.0 charging slot. This phone has glass and plastic back with the sandwich design. And if you are concerned about the quality, then it's good and it looks premium, but it's not because it's the cheap plastic. We have a big battery of 4000 mAh that can last for the 2 days with the full use. And you can get 10 hours of the continuous screen time. So if you are going to use the phone for the 10 hours continuously, then you can use it if your battery is at full 100%. So you might be thinking that why I haven't mentioned the processor. So it will come with the Helio P22 processor. So it's a mid-range, or you can say the budget processor. So if you are going to purchase a budget mobile phone, then you can purchase Helio P22 processor mobile phone, which is the Infinix S4, and you can play the PUBG and all other games on this phone easily. Now let's talk about its price and the variants. It comes with the 3GB variant and 32GB ROM, and also 4GB variant with 64GB ROM. If you are concerned about the prices, then the prices are 140 for the 3GB 32GB and 6GB 64GB is for the $180. So if you are watching this video, then you have the rights to know about the pros and cons of this mobile phone. So if you are going to buy the mobile phone, then I'm going to highlight that what are the pros and cons if you are going to purchase this mobile phone. So let's continue with the pros first. There are only two best things that I like about this phone. Number one is the Face ID. So you can use the Face ID to unlock your mobile phone. And the other thing is the front camera with the 1080p resolution. So you can record the 1080p videos with your front camera, like I'm doing it with my Poco F1. Now let's talk about the best section of this video, which are what are the disadvantages to purchase this phone. So my friends, there is no notification LED at the front side. There is no flashlight at the front like the previous Infinix phones have. Back of this mobile phone is the fingerprint magnet, And the major disadvantage of this phone that it comes with the 720p resolution, so you can watch the YouTube videos in the 720p resolution or any other videos in the 720p only. There is no image stabilization, there is no fast charging. You can charge your mobile phone with 2 hours and 15 minutes of continuously charging. So if you are going to purchase this phone, then you have to think about these advantages. And the major advantage of this Face ID is that you cannot unlock your mobile phone in the dark conditions, so the Face ID is not reliable at all. Now this is all and from my side, so if you are really interested to purchase this phone, then do let me know in the comment box. So if you like any feature and you are willing to purchase it then not purchase it, please do let me know what you think about this mobile phone. And if you like this video, please hit the like button. So either like or dislike, but do subscribe and don't forget to get notified for the more video. Thank you for watching. Take care. See you next time.